The Olympic Games is not just the world's foremost sporting event. This unique sporting festival can have huge benefits for a city, for a country, for its people and for its economy, which go far beyond those 2 weeks of competition and leave a lasting legacy.
It is getting more and more important that the future organizing committee understand that the success of the game will be the success of the legacies it can bring to the city or to the country or the regions.
To create a positive and sustainable legacy from the Olympic Games, a host city needs to plan early and have a long-term vision. And the process should start before a city even decides to bid.
Legacy is not simply going to happen because you think it's a good idea. It has to be enshrined in the bid. It then has to be enshrined in the master plan. So legacy was built into our designs.
If I take the Aquatic Centre, for example, we build for 17,500 capacity during games, reduce it right down to 2,500 post-games, and include within the pool design multiple floors that can be moved and the pool can be subdivided to ensure that the pool really offers that flexible facility for community use post-games.
A host city doesn't need to wait until after the Games to reap the benefits of Olympic legacy. The Vancouver 2010 Winter Olympics has been one of the most sustainable Games ever. They knew that the biggest project in the world needed a big vision to keep focused and inspired.
Sustainability was one of those values that every single person in the organization had to subscribe to, believe in. It became a part of everything that we did.
We wanted a place which would be the hub of activity for an entire neighborhood, and the catalyst for that was this Richmond Olympic Oval, and the catalyst for the Oval was the Olympic Games.
We dedicated this facility to the Olympic Games, but we didn't design and build it for the Olympic Games. We did it for community legacy, and that's where the payback is.
As a key part of their sustainability vision, the Vancouver Olympic Organizing Committee set up an extensive community-based training program to help produce the thousands of wooden products that were needed to run the Olympics.
There are people that are literally living on the streets, and through the help of these community organizations, we've changed their lives. They're getting paid a wage. You notice they start showing up in cleaner clothes, new clothes, things like that. It's amazing.
Any legacy objectives need to be realistic, and managing expectations is crucial. When London was bidding for the 2012 Games, its legacy vision was communicated and shared with all key stakeholders, including the public.
At the very beginning, the legacies we looked at, whether it was regenerating East London, whether it's about tourism, whether it's about more young people participating in sport, is making sure each of those stakeholders are there at the table at the beginning when you establish them. And if they are, then they take ownership in terms of delivering them.
During the planning and development of the bid, it was important to keep the community of Whistler engaged, and we actually included the community into the development of what were the very first set of commitments in our effort to be transparent.
For an Olympic legacy to work in the long term, it needs to be permanently locked into existing institutions, such as public authorities and businesses, organizations that will exist long after the Games have finished.
Well, at the moment, it's a park that's in East London. What we wanted to be is a park for East London. The fences will come down and we're going to stitch it back into the community. And it's not about us telling the community what they want, it's about them telling us what they want to see here.
The Aquatic Centre for the Olympic Games is very much used today. About 4.5 million people have visited Water Cube. Generally speaking, the citizens of Beijing, they want to go to Water Cube as a recreational area to have their children play there and people can go swimming there.
Today, legacy stands at the center of the Olympic Games, a vision that fits perfectly with the vision of Pierre de Coubertin to create a better world through the practice of sport.
If I try to find out the most valuable single legacy left by the Olympic Games, I would say it's the Olympic spirit. The Olympic spirit deeply affects the city and its population.
The most demanding stakeholder any city now has is actually not the International Olympic Committee, not government, not the mayor's office, not the National Olympic Committee. It's actually the population of the city and the country that you're delivering a Games. And the key question they ask beyond what is the Games going to look like and how is it going to impact on my community is, what are you leaving behind?